It's pocketable, it's waterproof, it offers 4K, and it has electronic image stabilization.
Damn.
GoPro, start recording. Dear high-tech fans, and welcome back to my channel. It's good to see you. Quick question before we start this review. Did you bring your towel? Ah, now we can talk. Are you new here?
Well, welcome. My name is Céline. I'm a TV journalist. If you enjoy watching high-tech reviews, tutorials, and sometimes vlogs, you should consider subscribing.
As soon as the GoPro Hero 7 was out, hundreds of reviews were out in the same time. So in this video, I'm not going to talk about the fact that it has many identical features with the GoPro Hero 6 Black. This topic has been repeated many times on other videos. Let's talk about its new feature, the electronic stabilization, which is called here for this camera, HyperSmooth. It's a dramatic improvement of the digital image stabilization compared to the other models. HyperSmooth takes that electronic stabilization to a high level. How does it work? Well, long story short, it's performed by cropping in slightly on the image and warping the edges to compensate for shake. On the new GoPro, HyperSmooth changes everything. It essentially boosts the electronic image stabilization of the GoPro Hero 7 Black beyond that of any motorized gimbal. Wait, am I sure 100% about that? It's hard to believe, right? Well, let's put it to the test. Not only does it work under normal handheld conditions, but it's equally as impressive when used by extreme sports enthusiasts catching a wave or base jumping. Le moment de vérité, the moment of truth. Let's see how it handled the stabilization compared to a gimbal like the Osmo Mobile 2. And if it succeeds, we could say that it competes quite well with the Osmo Pocket as well. The result is quite impressive, don't you think? As there is no mechanical gimbal to create the stabilized effect, you're no longer limited by an additional device. You might think the stabilization on the iPhone or the Samsung is pretty good, but your phone isn't an action camera. So the Hero 7 might just be the camera you reach for more often in a number of scenarios. That's interesting when you want to travel light but still have good quality image and stabilization. Next time I'll travel, I might not take my Osmo Mobile 2 with me. Oh, and one more thing. I have read so many comments of people crying for help because they thought their GoPro Hero 7 was broken. They couldn't activate the HyperSmooth. Something you need to keep in mind is that you can only select it when using 16:9 aspect ratio. That doesn't mean that you're without electronic image stabilization at 4/3. If you look closer into the settings, you'll find the option to switch on image stabilization. Once selected, you will be warned about the crop, but at least you'll have it. The second thing I'd like to talk to you about, and it's quite important for me, it's the audio quality of this GoPro. You see, GoPro has never been really good at making good quality audio. I only had two GoPros in my life. Before this one, the very, very first GoPro that I used a lot. And the Hero Session 5.
Ah, je vais me faire mal.
And both cameras had terrible sound quality. Well, now, thanks to its design, the waterproof membrane covers the microphone ports, meaning you won't hear the weird wind tunnel distortion style sound you are used to. And be prepared because you'll hear the difference with the GoPro Hero 7 that I'm testing right now. What do you think? You need me to talk a bit more so you can compare? Eh bien voilà, je parle. Alors c'est sympa le son. Qu'est-ce que vous en pensez?
I've just started to have fun with this camera, so I'll be leaving you with this explanation for now. I'll see you next week for more adventures. In the meantime, if you enjoyed my company, click on the thumbs up button just down. En dessous, below, give me a high five. And if you haven't done it yet, subscribe to my channel. Take care, relax, enjoy your Monday, and I will see you next week. Salut!